to Let's Play LaMulana. This is a game that came out about 3 years ago now. It's a rather interesting Metroidvania type game. I don't remember the control set. Since there's a tutorial at the beginning of this part, so that enemy dropped a green orb, an experience orb. At the top there's a green health bar and a blue experience bar. All it does though is when you collect half experience in the bar, it heals you. This game is originally came out for as a freeware game. It made some things easier, some things harder. I did beat the original version of this, so and let me give you guys a good look at this thing. Can't do anything about it. So, there are a couple things you need to do when you pick up some weights. I would like to be able to pick up the reader. Certainly need to pick up the shell. Oh. So for, between this and the first game, this one has a much better jumping physics and allows you to do a couple of tricks that you didn't do before. I played this a little bit when I first got it, but I don't have any time to play it, so this is a good excuse for me. Down a couple of rooms ago. You take a weight, throw it down on that, and you can solve puzzles or open chests or anything. The show horn will tell us if we activated the trap or solved the puzzle. So when you fall, you lose control, so if you fall, you have to fall, but you have a little bit of control if you jump. It's better than nothing. I think I have enough. chests respawn, but your stuff doesn't until you reload it. So over here is a hot spring. Outside of leveling, it's the only way that you can heal up. Well, that and picking the health up too. But in the original version, if you would save and reload it, fully heal you, it doesn't do that anymore. At least you can save at any time now. Instead of having to have the scanner. Sadly, it's the only time we're going to be hearing it for a long time. So it's the LaMulana script, we cannot read it yet. However, we can read skeletons. Some are sad, some are informational. Also, for once, I have the game and the chat up. Hey, this looks... that's the sound it makes when you complete a test. Sacred orbs heal you and increase your health by 32. That one seems to double our health. Don't eat it though. Some tablets are going to be useless to us. That's chest open. That I mean is that there's something sacred in this room. If you hit it, well, it's gonna shock us pretty badly. Let's not do that. first sub-weapon. Sure I can. Yeah, fire suit. Okay. So the controls are a little bit weird because you use your sub-weapon with C, you whip with X, jump with Z, and you use V to use whatever in your item that isn't your sub-weapon. And that's always good. I don't remember how much coin you needed for it, though. Obvious trap, I don't know what you're talking about. That's the sound it makes when you have a trap go off. Kind of this bad. That doesn't do anything for us because we don't have the paper with the it doesn't do anything for us for this moment. This does. Also, bats are annoying. The bats are annoying too. One sword. Oh, there's something good. Do it that way. Holy grail. Cool, now we can teleport. But only on tablets that we can move. So nothing.
Thank you.
Yes, you should. Okay, a guy. He's definitely closer to surface. I'll give that one more shot. Thank you. Zillion of the Giants. Thank you. So, now we can go fight the boss. We're not going to, but we can. Mausoleum of the Giants. Don't have a touch of this with giants before you do it. It's not the way I want to pass through the recent episode. That's one thing that I can really say about this game. It's got really enthralling lore. Sad memories of the giants.